Welcome to the Academy, a series focused on the basics of Star Wars: The Old Republic. The HK-51 Droid Companion is one of the most unique companions in Star Wars: The Old Republic, as unlike most companions which are earned through the story, HK-51 can only be earned through a long quest chain where the player rebuilds the droid after searching for scavenged parts that have been hidden across the galaxy. In this video, we'll be going over everything you need to know about the HK-51 questline. The first thing you need to know is that HK-51 is not directly available for free-to-play or preferred players, as the quest chain to earn him is locked to either subscribers or to players who have the Section X cartel market unlock. This map, this section, was created early in the game's lifetime, and the developers were testing out locking certain areas behind a subscription or unlock, similar to how expansions work, except you lose access if you later unsubscribe, unlike the expansion areas. If you're currently a subscriber, you can just fly to the quest start. Otherwise, if you're either free to play or preferred, if you do want to do this quest line, you'll need to purchase the cartel market item called Access Authorization Section X, which costs 375 cartel coins per character, or about 4 months worth of free cartel coins from a security key. There's also technically an account-wide version of this cartel market unlock available, but I recommend just purchasing it for one character rather than your account, as there's a character unlock that will allow you to unlock HK-51 for each of your characters once you've earned him the first time. To complete this HK-51 quest, you'll need a level 50 character, and you'll also need a second character on the opposite faction who has completed their first planet, as you'll need to go searching for a piece on both Dromund Kaas, Imperial side, and on Coruscant, Republic side. To start the quest, head to this Section X area of Belsavis, a daily area that is separate from the rest of the planet and has a separate landing point on the galaxy map if you're flying there on your ship. The droid quest giver is really close to where you land on the shuttle in Section X. Republic side, the droid is named B631, and Imperial side, the droid is named GOA1. The droid quest giver will send you to another NPC named Bren on Republic side or General Avron Imperial side on a different map nearby. After you've picked up the story part of the quest, the second step of the quest is the Fatality, a crashed ship you'll need to travel through to reach the broken HK droid. This part of the quest can be done alone or with up to a group of four. The quest is labeled as a heroic 2+ quest, but most players will be able to solo this entire quest chain. There's no real secrets here. Just travel through the broken ship, fight or sneak past anything along the way until you find the damaged droid storage. From there, you'll be asked to return back outside to Bren or General Avron. The third step of the quest is the Theoretika, a really unique environment that's a lot of fun to explore. Just like the last step, this part of the quest can be done alone or with up to a group of four. If you're grouping up, tell everyone in your group to open their galaxy map and fly to the Theoretika, which will be at the top of the map, and meet there. The Theoretika is an explorational puzzle area where you'll need to explore the abandoned ship and figure out how to unlock its various doors until you reach the research area hidden deeper in the ship. In addition to unlocking the ship, there's an additional bonus mission where you can search through the ship for 7 hidden data logs that will show you a short cutscene that better explains what happened to the ship and why it was abandoned. The ship is designed to be a bit spooky, and if possible, I recommend exploring it in the dark. But if you need it, you can either turn down the graphics so you can see better with less shadows, or, and more commonly, you can turn on the flashlight by clicking the icon that shows up beside the quest on the top right of your screen. In your quest log, it looks like a yellow flashlight. If you ever lose your flashlight, you can turn it back on from your quest log. To turn the flashlight off, you can right-click the icon of the flashlight above your character portrait as a buff. So rather than providing a guide to the Theoretika in this video, I recommend just exploring the ship and seeing what you can find, as the main goal of the quest is to be explorational. If you get stuck, however, I'm going to be making a second video about a guide to the Theoretika, and I also have a step-by-step guide on how to unlock all the doors and how to find all the data logs in the written version of this guide, linked in the description below. If you wanted to do the bonus stuff and not miss out on anything, you'll want to make sure to find all 7 data logs and create a Nihilite injector. However, you can still go back and find the data logs even after you complete the final part of the Theoretika if you accidentally did things in the wrong order. So as long as you don't leave the ship, you don't have to worry too much about missing out by exploring on your own. If you decide to follow all the leads and explore the entire Theoretika, you'll be treated to a special room with a bonus puzzle to solve that I won't spoil for you, but if you need help, I also have the instructions for that in the written guide. After you leave the Theoretika, you'll be sent on a hunt across the galaxy to find 7 different HK parts. 5 are hidden on planets, and 2 are hidden in flashpoints. There are hints about where each of these pieces are hidden in the quest log. You must have completed the Theoretika quest, and you must be on this step of the quest before you can pick up the HK pieces. If you're not on this step, you can still find the pieces, but you won't be able to use them or properly pick them up. So the first piece is the HK transistor, and it's hidden in Outlaw's Den on Tatooine. Republic side, the closest quick travel will be Outpost Solara, then run south. Imperial side, the closest quick travel or taxi is Mos Anik, then run north. Or of course, if you have the Outlaw's Den quick travel, you can use that. You're looking for a Jawa vendor in the south section of Outlaw's Den named Kizit, and you'll need to buy the wrapped HK transistor item, which can be right-clicked in your inventory to receive the quest item. It costs 125,000 credits. This Jawa also sells the Burba Seismic Excavator / Scanner. You got one for free by doing the Theoretika quest, but if you ever lose the one you got, you can rebuy it from this Jawa vendor for 50,000 credits. This scanner item is legacy bound, which means you can transfer it between your characters through your legacy bank or mail. The next part of the HK-51 quest, tracking down the other pieces, can be done alone or in a large group of up to 24 players. As long as all players are working together and communicating, the more players searching, the faster it will go, as when one player finds a hidden piece, all other players can also then find it. The second piece, the HK chassis, is on Taris near the Endar Spire shipwreck. The fastest way to get to Taris is using the Activities Panel Solo Tab Heroic Shuttle. The closest Republic quick travel and taxi is Waypoint Station Arak in the center of the map. The closest Imperial taxi and quick travel is the Tower Command Station, also near the center of the map. From either of those, run to the right on the map, to the east, and look for the giant crashed ship. Imperial side is going to look a little different, as the map will be in the nighttime rather than the daytime, like Republic side. This is where you start using your Burba Seismic Excavator Scanner item. The way it works is that the HK piece you are searching for is hidden somewhere in the map, and you can use the scanner to find it. Right-clicking the scanner from your inventory will place it down on the ground, and it will search 2 meters around you, 5 meters around you, 10 meters, and then 25, which is shown by the circles that appear around your character. If you don't find anything, move to a new location outside the range of the largest green circle that appeared. Try again, covering the map you best you can in a series of large circles. Once you find a piece, it will tell you how far away it is as a hint. You can use that hint to triangulate the piece's exact location. If it's within 25 meters, go just outside your green circle's radius and check again. If you get another hit, it will be somewhere between your new circle and your old circle, like an overlapping Venn diagram. If you don't get a hit, it will probably be on the other side of your original circle. If you're searching for pieces as part of a large group, have one player get to the location and then summon the rest, to prevent players accidentally finding a piece before the others get there. Have your group spread out and start looking. When a player finds a piece, have them say in chat how far away the piece is, for example 25 meters or 5 meters away from them. When that happens, all players should open their map and find that player by rolling their mouse over the purple dots on the map representing players and run to them and start searching nearby. Once one player finds them, a yellow light will appear in the air and all players in the group should rush over to it and right-click the piece before it disappears. It will only be visible for 1 minute, then disappear and be hidden in a brand new random location, so anyone who wasn't fast enough getting to it will need to start the search all over. For the piece on Taris, it can be found anywhere near the Endar Spire or its surrounding area, especially to the east and west, technically outside of the Endar Spire's map area. It's a pretty big area to search, so I wish you good luck. The third piece, the AI Regulator, is hidden in the Jedi Temple on Coruscant and is only findable by Republic characters. So if you're doing the rest of the quest on an Imperial character, hop over to a Republic one. Make sure to also give them the scanner either through the Legacy Bank or your mailbox. The fastest way to get there is to take the Heroic Shuttle to Coruscant through the Activities panel in the Solo tab, then pick up the Enemies of the Republic Heroic from the Heroics Terminal and take the Heroic Shuttle and run north to the Jedi Temple elevator. Otherwise, just quick travel or taxi to the Jedi Temple. This HK part can be found almost anywhere in the Jedi Temple, including on top of broken pillars. It doesn't seem to be hidden in the secret second floor though. There's a lot of ground to cover in the Coruscant Jedi Temple, but at least the map is clear where it will be. Instead of a mission item, you'll get a normal item that you can right-click to consume. It looks like a droid head. If you are doing the main quest on an Imperial character and just hopped on a Republic character to look for the part in the Jedi Temple, you can now send both the head item and the scanner item back to your Imperial character, as the special head item is legacy bound. Once it's on the right character, right-click it from your inventory. The fourth piece, the Motivator, is hidden in the Dark Temple approach on Dromund Kaas and is only findable by Imperial characters. It's hidden in a really big area. Most players start near the temple doors and work their way south down the temple approach. Just like on Coruscant, instead of a mission item, you'll get a normal item that you can right-click to consume. If you're doing the main quest on a Republic character and just hopped on an Imperial character to look for the part in the Sith Temple, you can now send both the Motivator item and the scanner back to your Republic character, as the special Motivator item is legacy bound. Once it's on the right character, right-click it from your inventory. It looks kind of like an arm or a piece of machinery. The fifth piece, the Power Core, is hidden on Hoth, near the wreck of the Ambrius Fury ship, which is in the north of the Glacial Fissure map. The fastest way to get their Republic side is to use the Heroic Shuttle to get to Hoth, then pick up the Heroic Quest, the Terror Brigade, and just run to the left. Otherwise, quick travel to Outpost Wreck and run one map to the left. Imperial side, the closest quick travel and taxi is probably Thesh Outpost, then run northeast to the top right of the map. There's a really big area to search. Try searching along and in the wreckage in a loop around the ship, then move outwards if you don't find it. Don't forget to search in the cracks between the ship where it's broken too. The map I'm showing isn't an exact area where you can find the part, it's just a general location of where the ship is. The sixth piece, the HK Weapons Protocol, is hidden in the False Emperor Flashpoint. The Flashpoint can be run on story mode, and the piece will drop directly from the HK-47 boss for any players who are on the right step of the HK-51 questline. As far as I can tell, you don't need to finish the Flashpoint if you just want to continue working on earning HK-51. It seems like you can run this in story, veteran, or master mode. Lots of players reported it works in solo, and my group personally run it in veteran mode. The seventh piece, the final piece, is the loyalty chip, which is available to pick up at the end of either the Maelstrom Prison Flashpoint Republic side or the Foundry Flashpoint on Imperial side. The Flashpoint can be run on story mode alone or with a group. Just a heads up, there may be some bugs involved if you try and run it on veteran mode for the part, so it's recommended to run it on either story mode, even if you're running it in a group, or you can technically run it in master mode. Even the quest itself says story or master, not veteran. So super important about actually picking up these pieces. Republic side, the piece is available at the very end of the Flashpoint before you leave. It's after the final boss, in the room behind the final boss, and you want to pick it up from a glowing blue crate before you leave the Flashpoint. Imperial side, you will need to complete the entire Flashpoint of the Foundry, including the final boss, and the HK piece will be available from a small glowing blue holopad to the right of the large blue terminal that ends the Flashpoint. You'll want to grab it before finishing the Flashpoint directly after defeating the final boss. Once you've found all the pieces, including using the ones in your inventory, you'll be sent back to Section X, where you'll return to the Fatality and meet your new droid companion. Once you've earned HK-51 on one character, you do not have to go through the steps to get him a second or third time on other characters. Instead, there's a special legacy unlock that becomes available after you earn him the first time. To unlock HK-51 for your other characters, go to your legacy window. then into your character perks, and there will be a perk called HK-51 on the right side. Click the one with a credit symbol, and you'll be able to pay 1 million credits to unlock HK-51 on your character. You'll need to pay the 1 million credits for every character you want to unlock him on, or you can re-earn him by doing the HK-51 quest all over again on that character. Once you've gotten HK-51, if you want to make him stronger, you'll want to raise his influence with companion gifts. HK-51 loves military gear best. He'll also accept maintenance and weapons gift as a second favorite, and lastly, likes technology and trophy gifts as well. There is one fun little perk that comes along with HK-51, and that's HK-51's purple crystal. If you're looking for a purple crystal, once you've earned HK, the weapon he comes with includes a free purple eviscerating crystal that you can use even on a free-to-play or preferred account once you remove it from the weapon. It's a plus 36 purple crystal, so not quite as good as the normal purple crystals you can get on the GTN, but it's unique as it does not require artifact authorization. And lastly, let's talk about bugs. First off, another reminder that you can't run Maelstrom Prison or the Foundry in Veteran mode. The piece will not be available there, only in Story and Master. And second, there are a bunch of cases where HK's 51 quest, where you go get the different pieces from around the galaxy, may reset. It often goes back to the point where you have to do the Theoretika. I have not figured out what causes this quest, but when we did it in a group of about 40 players, one of the players did have this happen, and other players have also reported that they got reset back to the Theoretika. Another player who wasn't in our group said they had a similar problem. They were able to go back and redo the Theoretika, but the nice part was once they got to the next step of the quest, where you go look for the HK parts, they were able to keep the parts that they've already kept. So it's unfortunate you get reset back to that Theoretika step, but at least you've done it before, and you can run through the Theoretika fairly quickly the second time around. I unfortunately don't know what causes this. If you ever can figure it out, let me know in the comments below. There may also be some funky stuff that happens if you're partway through the quest and you lose access to Section X. For example, if you're a subscriber, you're doing the HK-51 quest and your subscription ends before you finish it. I have no idea what happens in that case, so I recommend, if that's the case, finish up that quest before you get unsubscribed. I hope you enjoyed this extremely in-depth video about how to go get the HK-51 companion, one of the most interesting and complex companions to get in all of Star Wars The Old Republic. If you want to show your support for these crazy guides about the game that you love, visit SWTOR.com/support to pledge your allegiance to the cause. And if you want to have similar Star Wars The Old Republic videos show up on your YouTube homepage, subscribe to this channel. As always, declaration. May the Force be with you.